Did you see the treasure chest? That's a shocker.
Because I had my kill fire up there, I step all
quick and took off the ring, and I come back and hopped and it's fallen off. And they broke. They were little flowers, is what they were. Yeah, I know, it does look kind of good. I glued them together, but look at that. I put a wooden arch underneath saying it's it actually been lifted up. Yeah. It's the same on both sides almost. use in sequence. Sisters, Kathy. Mary Garlic, Mother, Mars Garlic, Maiden, whatever she is, she's out there. Anyway, we've had help making cookies this year, and we have volunteers. But that doesn't answer your question, right? I inherited some money about, I don't know, 5 years ago or something, and rather than spend it on going on trips to the Bahamas, I spend it on Maestro Day. And that's what I do. I just, I hired an airplane to fly over with Maestro Day on it, and I thought it was, Mrs. Starbucks started with 8 people or something in a little coffee clutch, and Les Blankets is telling me, and his crew is over here, working right here. You can give them a hand if you'd like.
training.
Well, I would be happy to see more dressed this way. This is how I dress. And Picasso wore the stripes, but I wear the hat. That's the way I like to do it. The thing is, if you get cast, you get stereotyped real easy this way. People think that you're either eccentric in a funny way, or that you that you're a very, very macho redneck or something. And I don't think that's the case with me. I don't feel I'm that way at all. Maybe the image comes across. I don't know, but I'm not into any of that macho stuff. I just like the dress. I like this stuff. Nice stuff. And I've never been out of style. I mean, you can see me 20 years from today, and I have these same boots on. You say, hey, all right. Start out with a pair of shoes. Yes. Who was the first cowboy that I know of? You mean the first cowboy that I remember seeing? I think it may have been Ken Maynard. I'm not sure. He was an old movie cowboy. All I did when Sam Lewis was go to see movies and then right back to the ranch. So that's all I ever got to see. And that set my mindset when I was very young, that cowboys were the only thing that were around. Because I had to go into town to see them, see? And I didn't associate with people in town. My mother would drive me in. We'd go to the movie and she'd be waiting when we got out. And we'd get out and go right back to the ranch. So all I ever saw was cowboys in town and cows on the ranch. So I thought that's what the world was like. So I got to high school. Man, was this different in there, huh? What's happening here, you know? And they freaked me out. So anyway, here I am. Any more questions? I know it's getting hot. Cookies are ready! Cookies are ready! If anybody would like to stay for the Blue Cowboy Lounge Show, as soon as we set up the stage, we'll be starting it up, and you can hear a few songs. Won't take too long. You might enjoy it. But thank you for coming. I'm sorry we had to put you out.
Ton of steel thunders down the road. Cadillac life has changed on this. From all the work you did back in the past, like driving the cow across that lonesome prairie, the only thing he drives today is fast. Cadillac driving to Reno. Cadillac driving to Reno. If you think a cowboy's life is nothing, if he ain't upon his trusty steed, just looking through this thing called evolution, you'll find he's still right up there in the lead. Cadillac driving to Reno. Cadillac driving to Reno.
Do you like my new piano?
Yeah.